Bismillah, Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. Dear friends, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your siyam and qiyam. The litmus test for me to judge people if they are ignorant is when it comes to Islam treatment of women. Historically and briefly, women in the history of mankind, they've been abused, neglected, taken advantage of, all the way to nowadays. Women are victims. And they've been taken advantage of by the smarter men. They convince them, the more clothes they take off their skin, they will be successful and making money more. At any rate, Islam, briefly, uplifted the women to the level of men. And I'm not talking about equality where everyone talk about it. I'm talking about fairness and justice. One of the best books I read about the women treatment in Islam is this book by محمد عزة دروزة محمد عزة دروزة المرأة في القرآن والسنة. I have no time to talk about the women in Jahiliyyah, how they were treated. Let us take the testimony of Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه. In this picture, he and his wife, he was given order. And his wife didn't like what he's saying or ordering, and she talked back to him. And Omar is a giant who everyone is scared of him, including the devil himself. Wherever Omar is walking, the devil goes to the other side of the street. So Omar ibn al-Khattab said, والله إنا كنا في الجاهلية ما نعد للنساء أمرا. In the Jahiliyyah, the period before Islam, we considered women to be nothing. حتى أنزل الله فيهن ما أنزل وقسم لهن ما قسم. Till the orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran came and gave him the rights and a lot of details about the women from the birth all the way to death. And we know in the Quran there is a big part of it related to women. In Surah Al-Baqarah, there's a lot of issues related to women, and Surah Ali Imran, and Surah An-Nisa, and Surah At-Talaq, Surah Al-Mumtahina, all of them, they have a lot of part of them dedicated to all the conditions of women. Addressed the hatred when somebody's wife put birth to a girl, in many, many ayahs, and rebuking them and this type of mentality. It immediately, after receiving the revelation and so on, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam addressed the issue of the female infanticide, which was kind of spread among poor and so on, and some tribes. It addressed the upbringing of the girls educating them, having them to be ready to be married and be a productive part of society. They were encouraged to do business and vocational, like making baskets and so on and selling them. And the freedom of using that money as they like. So this is حق الكسب والتصرف في المال. So they have their financial. Nowadays we have problems for some women have problem, you know, opening an account in the bank. On the issue of the inheritance laws all over the world is chaotic. You can give all what you have to your dog. No question asked, or deprive your children and give it to whoever, girlfriend. Islam put the very, very accurate laws for inheritance, which redistribute the wealth and prevent it from accumulating at the end up in the hands of few. I gave a lecture about Fibonacci numbers and the Islamic inheritance laws. It is amazing. Of course, those ignorant people tell you about لِلذَكَرِ مِثْلُ حَظِّ الْأُنْثَيَيْنِ. Oh, look, he's a tree. No, this is very simply the duties and responsibility, economic and so on, or the male is twice as much as the female, or more than twice. The female takes her portion and put it in the bank, no question asked, while the male has to spend on his mother, his sister who is not married, on his wife, on his daughters, all of them. He is the one responsible financially for their support. Marriage, Islam encouraged marriage, made it half of the deen. Half of Islam is to go out and get married. Nowadays, everyone is attacking the institute of marriage, the normal one which everyone knows for the last centuries in all religions and so on. It's unfortunately nowadays has been attacked big time. In the Quran, we find chapters about marriage and the marriage life and the divorce and the intimacy and so on and so on. We come to the issue of polygamy. Also, we are on the headline news. Well, polygamy, number one, is well known all over cultures, religions, ages, and so on, all the way till nowadays. Now they attack the relation with the male, or relation to a female, if there's a contract. That's what marriage. But if there's no contract, it's okay. And we have amazing number of people having a relation with women without any responsibility. I read in Hite Report and Johnson and all of these amazing figures. I don't want to mention in this holy month what sport superstars and movie stars and so on, how many women they abused or slept with. At any rate, polygamy is well known all over Islam what it did. And again, I repeat that the ayah which talk about 2, 3, 4 came in the context of protecting the girls who are orphans and their father died and somebody, a relative, etc., have a custody on their money and them. So they go ahead and marry that girl without love, without just for the money, to take the money. And here the prohibition came, don't touch them. You go out there and marry 2, 3, 4 as you. But at that time, they didn't have to have a permission. They marry 10 and 20 and 40. So here came and prohibited. We have many hadith. Taylan ibn Salama had 10 ladies, wives. So the Prophet told them, you choose four and let the rest out to divorce them, and so on. Another one, same thing. And so Islam came and this 2, 3, 4 is under strict laws. And if there is no, the court, the judge can tell him, no, you stick with one only. At any rate, you know, the sexual relation, men and women, is a chaotic thing in the whole society. We know it. Everyone knows it. But when it comes to write a contract for the right of women not to be abused, oh, everyone raise hell. Of course, the men want free lunch. They don't want obligations. They don't want to take care of any baby out of the wedlock. They don't want any responsibility. And they pass laws to protect that, of course. It's a foxy man who their pleasure to strip them naked. And this is the design of the shaitan in the beginning. يَنْزِعُ عَنْهُمَا لِبَاسَهُمَا لِيُرِيَهُمَا سَوْآتِهِمَا. And you know, amazing. I mean, even those designer houses, the fashion gurus, most of them are homosexual, gays. But they make the design and so on to strip the women naked. This is the culture nowadays. Women are for sexual pleasure. From the advertisement all the way to the pornography all the way. This is what they call objectification. Islam, of course, there's nothing except marriage, period. Marriage, as was known from previous generation, religions, etc., Christianity, Judaism, all of it, marriage, where there is a dowry, there is witnesses, there is agreement, and so on. We know all these things. Even when the woman become a widowed, you know, Islam lifted the status of the widows big time. It's enough that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except for Aisha, most of them are widowed, one or two divorced. Aisha is the only, radiallahu anha, the only one who was a virgin or bikr. The laws of the woman who is widowed to make hidad or idda for months and 10 days has many legal things, you know. Number one, to make sure she's not pregnant from the deceased husband, and also emotional and hormonal and so on. It you know, just to make sure she's gonna come back to the baseline. Other cultures, I don't want to mention, when the husband dies, the woman is burned with the husband, burned alive, and the husband is dead. I know it's illegal nowadays where they practice this. Anyway, my point here, anyone who discredit Islam treatment of the women, he is ignorant and he doesn't know. I am a scientist, a doctor, versed into the 20th century and 21st century affairs and everything. And I believe strongly that the solution for the women misery lies in following the teaching of Islam in the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, she will be treated like a cat in the heat, where those male cats chasing her from one corner to another corner. And this is the situation nowadays. It's unfortunate. Islam protected the woman by knowing that there is something entrusted on her, the secondary sexual attraction or characteristics. This is shielded. The only avenue for it, for male to come and touch it, is marriage. And that investment lasts for life, where the woman grows older and she loses all the appeal of the youth and so on, but she has children, she becomes a queen. As a matter of fact, the queens, they are treated by the public in their Islamic way. She's shielded. Nobody can come and shake hands with her. On the other hand, Islam promotes the woman education, vocation, business, and everything related to the new cortex, related to the rational brain. She can become a doctor, a lawyer, a engineer, she can become a teacher, she can become, of course, it encourages those professions which tend to be women related, like teachers and doctors and pharmacists, etc., etc. The misery index is very high everywhere, and every ism has been tried except Islam, been attacked right and left. I mean, had no time to breathe. And it is a solution, it's amazingly. Of course, big part of the problem is the Muslims themselves. They gave the ugly picture about treatment of women in Islamic countries, call it, quote-unquote, Islamic countries. I don't know why they call it Islamic countries. They are third world countries. They are ignorant countries. The education is very low. The illiteracy very high. Full of poverty and disease, and it's very primitive societies all over. It's a culture which is running the show. The women, they don't get, they have to come up with a dowry. I mean, upside down. Dowry, all the fuqaha, they tell you it's a must. It doesn't matter how little or how big. The same thing, inheritance in all over the Muslim, or let's call it third world countries, they don't inherit the woman. They take everything, the males. They deprive her from her inheritance. And so on and so on. The abuse is big time. But again, I can tell you, in the third world countries, not only women abused, men abused, children abused. You go and see. And unfortunately, the whole world is involved. So there is no one single party which is guilty all over the world, achieving their politics and so on, and ripping off the wealth of and so on, and banks, and you name it. It's not our subject. When I visited not too long ago, I mean, I saw the cats are miserable. Some of them without tail and others without ears, and even their whiskers are shaved. I saw a couple of cats been abused. I mean, it's a sad situation, but please don't blame Islam. Islam is above all of that. And it is a solution in my judgment. May God bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.